Welcome back to the Air of Authority. My name is Andrea, and today I'm going to call my dad, who's been a heating and air conditioning technician for the past 41 years, and I'm going to ask him three specific questions about heat exchangers. One, how long does a heat exchanger last? Two, can a heat exchanger be replaced by itself? And three, how do I know if my heat exchanger is bad? So if you are a homeowner and you would like weekly tips for your heating and air conditioning system that can save you money, please subscribe and keep watching. How long does a heat exchanger last?
There is no answer to that. It's almost like how long does a car last? Kind of depends on how it's been used. It also depends on how it's been installed.
In general, how long does it last?
Yeah, I don't want to give misinformation because it used to be common, 20 years. A furnace lasts 20 years. Once it's 20 years old, it probably needs to be replaced. And if it's 15 years old, it's probably fine. Really kind of found that that's really not the case. As technology changed, as far as how we can check a furnace, it's improved dramatically over the years. And so we can test things and see things that we couldn't ever see before. To give a blanket X number of years is really a disservice because for me to say, 10 years, well, gosh, there's furnaces that last longer than 10 years when they're installed properly, and which means they're going to be operating properly, the proper temperature rise and that sort of thing over the life of the furnace. We sell furnaces, we'll get this, with lifetime warranties, meaning if it ever fails, we'll give you a new one. And I've not seen that heat exchanger fail. Yeah, out in the field. So there are some that are built that well, but still you can install it improperly and it won't last at all. Conversely, just like with everything else, there's cheap ones out there. And so you can see cheap ones even installed well just by poor design, and it's just not going to last very long. We have seen furnaces just a few years old fail. Once that happens to you, it's kind of hard to sit here and say, 10 years. Typically, they're going to last 10 years. Well, I don't want to be the person telling you it's going to last 10 years when you're sitting there with a 3-year-old failed heat exchanger. So it's one of those things we always check. It's a primary safety concern that we have. The heat exchanger is sound. And if it does fail, you deserve a new one.
This is a situation where a warranty is kind of a big deal. For a heat exchanger warranty in particular.
I'm not aware of a furnace that has less than a 10-year warranty on the heat exchanger. Now, understand that's going to be a parts only, typically. That means the manufacturer is going to give you a new heat exchanger, and the homeowner is going to pay a technician the labor involved in replacing it, which can be a rather extensive thing. It's kind of the heart of the furnace, so you disassemble a good part of the furnace to change a heat exchanger. But, I don't want to scare a person there. Sometimes it's not as big a deal as what you might think.
If the heat exchanger is bad, can just the heat exchanger be replaced instead of having to replace the whole furnace?
No, absolutely. It definitely is a serviceable, replaceable item on the furnace, right?
How does somebody know if their heat exchanger is bad?
You don't know if you have a bad heat exchanger. That's why it's so important to have it properly checked and tuned up, and someone checking it that's got the tools and the technology available to really check it out. Because you really don't know. In most cases, a furnace with a failed heat exchanger can still operate. But the problem is now you have this gap, this crack, this void between separating those products of combustion with the air that's circulated throughout the house. And so typically it's going to still function. The homeowner isn't going to be aware that there could be a very, very, very serious problem with the safety of the furnace. Now, the new furnaces are much smarter than the old furnaces are. It used to be you could, this is 30 years ago, a furnace had very few safety controls on it as far as if there was a problem with the venting, a problem with the combustion process. I mean, there were no safeties on it whatsoever. Today, there are. There are safeties involved that are all built into the furnace to, if there's a situation that is dangerous or if it's not burning properly, it'll turn itself off. And so another reason to sometimes people find these little reset buttons where the furnace might be having a problem and, all I had to do is reset this button and it came back on. Well, guess what? Mm. There was probably something going on there that
it might have turned off for a reason.
It did turn off for a reason. It wasn't a fluke. It didn't just mistakenly trip and turn itself off. And the homeowner isn't going to be aware of that. You know, all they know is, gosh, it just must be a fidgety little switch. You know, all I have to do is hit that reset button and it comes back on.
Then I think that answers the question, except for the first one. How long does it last?
Which you couldn't pin me down. You weren't pinning me down on that one. Couldn't get me to say it.
But I think that does answer the question, that it can last.
I hope it lasts a lifetime.
Yeah, it could last that long.
I hope it lasts forever and that you never have to deal with it. It operates safely. As long as you own it, it's operating safely and you never had to go to the trouble or expense of replacing it. And that is possible. That is possible.
All right. Thank you very much.